and welcome to Federal Bank Let's Talk. Guess where I am? Serene backwaters and an enchanting environment. Here I am at the Ravi's Kollam, and with me a very special guest. A world-renowned industrialist that Kerala is proud of. He has to his credit more than a dozen business enterprises, an NRI entrepreneur, a business tycoon, a philanthropist. Guess who? Today we have with us Padma Shri Dr. Ravi Pillai. Let's talk. Fondly referred to as the Ambani of the Gulf. So before we talk about being Ambani, will you first tell us about how and why Gulf?
Last 32 years, we are doing business in the Gulf, Saudi Arabia, Qatar, Dubai and Abu Dhabi and Kuwait. Okay. Around 70,000 people working with me in the Gulf countries. It's a booming place in the world, Gulf.
But what prompted you to go to the Gulf? I want the story of the growth of your business empire.
I started my business in Cochin Refinery and Vellore Newsprint. Okay. Some labor strike came, then I moved to Saudi Arabia.
Okay, Saudi Arabia was a far
away. I visited 1979. I started my business in Saudi, the place called Al-Khobar.
Okay.
We started my business with 150 people. Mm-hmm. Now 70,000. That is, the growth. What is the reason?
Okay. In our minds, Saudi Arabia, the picture of Saudi Arabia is a very conservative, very difficult place to do business. But your experience seems to be different.
I visited all over the world. The best place in the world, the earth, to make money only Saudi Arabia.
Okay.
There's a rule there. You must work under the rules.
You have the distinction of being the largest employer of Indians in the Gulf.
Yes.
Is this a conscious decision? Is this a decision by choice to incorporate more and more Indians in your establishment?
Yes.
You do it on purpose?
No, our company working, we are an international company, working Americans, Japanese, Koreans, Philippines, Nepalese, South Africans, then Canadians, all are working with us.
Okay.
The key people working with Indians, the engineers. My company, more than 20,000 engineers will be working with my company. Mm-hmm. We are employing every year the fresh engineers, minimum 1,500 to 2,000 people.
From India. Okay.
That, like that, we are working for Sri Lanka and Philippines mostly. Mm-hmm.
Now, what does this distinction mean to you personally, that you are able to give employment to so many Indians?
I like Indians, especially Kerala people.
Okay.
Within the 2 years experience, the Indian people or Kerala people, they are brilliant than Europeans.
Okay.
They are very sincere and loyal. That's why you could be Indians.
Okay. You said you have people from across the globe working with you. You have Canadians, Americans, everybody. What are your general observations on the people of India who work for you? What kind of people are we?
I tell you, I am keeping the foreigners, Americans or British, other people, as ornaments.
Okay.
They're only ornaments. Okay, we are American. Actually, the job is doing Indians.
Okay.
Mm. They're smart people.
Okay. And what about people from Kerala? There's an often repeated comment that we Keralites are very hardworking. but hardworking only when we leave the borders of our home state. Is that true in your experience?
My company, many people working more than 30 years, Kerala people, they have good experience because they are very loyal, hardworking than other states.
So your hometown is Kollam, Chavara.
Yeah.
So you have a lot of people from this part of the country also?
No, not really, everywhere.
From all over?
All over the world.
You hold a very large diversified portfolio. You have interests in coal, petroleum, steel, tourism, education.
Yeah.
So what next?
This is a very important news. I'm going to start my business in Australia.
Okay.
May my office will start in Australia.
Okay.
This is a golden opportunity in Australia.
Okay.
Oil and gas and mines.
Okay.
For that purpose, we are going to establish an institute in India.
Okay.
Training people for working for Australia.
What kind of work is that?
This is another interesting country, world. There's Australia, there's a lot of mines, coal, gold, and gas.
Okay. So you will be training people from India to work in these?
Yeah, I'm planning because Australia trade union very, very strong. So we like to employ more Australians, more than 80 or 85%. 15% people we can import from outside.
Okay. So where are you planning to set up this institute?
First, the institute we are going to start
in Kollam.
Kollam.
Okay.
Kollam or Chavara.
See, there are a lot of philanthropic activities that the Ravi Pillai Foundation is doing. The mass wedding ceremony that you conducted sometime back hit the headlines. What are the other initiatives under this?
Maybe 2013, another mass marriage.
Okay.
I don't know any another applications. I put a marriage next year, 2013, end of 2013. This is a plan.
What about this Ravi's? The idea, where was this born? The idea of opening such a seven-star resort in Kollam?
I traveled all over the world. I like to bring my friends to Kerala or Kollam. There's no good hotel. That is why I started this.
Okay. And are they happy now?
They are very happy. In Aversion, more than 40 countries people visited here. They are very happy. So through that care of many people are coming to India.
What is your idea of taking a break?
So for me, there's no break. I can't stay without job in 1 hour.
Okay.
I'm always busy.
Always
I start working. My life day. If I am Saudi Arabia or Middle East, I start 5 o'clock. Stop 11 o'clock. Completing.
Okay, you work throughout.
Throughout the day. So most of the time, my house in the sky. I always traveling.
Will you tell us a little about your family?
My family, my wife named Kida. My son Ganesh Revipulli, then daughter Aradhi Revipulli. My son studying, so not studying now, is working for Citibank, Bahrain.
Okay.
My daughter in final year medicine in India.
Okay. Were you the kind of person to set definite goals and reach those goals, or has all that happened?
Yes.
As it is. What kind of person are you?
No, I was born from an agriculture family. Landlords in Chavara, many people working with me in our village. Then after my graduation, then I thought I start my business, not for a job.
Okay.
When
so why? Because generally I think most, especially in those days, who would think of setting up a business after graduation?
I don't know. When I was, I think, 14 years, I thought of business. When I studied in college, I was studying, there was Bodh College Shastra, I started my business.
What business was that?
Then it's called a chitti business.
Okay. And while you were doing your graduation,
and
you started?
Trading, yes.
Okay.
Then I moved to for MBA course, I went to Cochin. Then I got many friends, then I started construction business. Same business I started in Middle East also.
Okay. So it's been, construction has been one major
That is my core business.
That's your core.
My main revenue is coming from construction.
Okay.
We are doing around $2.5 billion business annually. We are doing in Middle East.
You must be recruiting with people at different skill levels.
Yes.
So how is it managing different kinds of people at different skill levels?
We have a training department. Many people recruited to India or Philippines. There's a training department. They will train the people as per outside the conditions.
What are the common qualities that you look for in the people that you recruit?
We are looking at the quality people, sincere and loyalty. That's the main thing. That's so they can work many years. If anybody come to Gulf, they can easily get minimum 25,000 rupees. They can save okay. every month. Mm-hmm. Then we'll provide free food and accommodation. Okay. If you could work, they will get more time, more hours, they get more money.
What is the current job market scenario in the Middle East?
There's a shortage of manpower everywhere in the world.
It's a shortage?
Yes.
Okay.
So we are searching.
So we are not talking about a crisis and people, unemployment people.
No, no crisis, there's a shortage of manpower.
There's a shortage
everywhere.
Of manpower.
Okay. So we need people now, we are even training in North India also. Then only we can get the people.
So Kerala can still look forward to the Gulf being.
There's another 10 to 15 years, there's a golden chances. When Australia another 20 years, golden chances.
What do you think of the current investment climate in Kerala? Are we an investor friendly state? Are industrialists afraid to come to Kerala?
This is a golden time now to invest in Kerala. There's a very good climate, hard-working people, so we can invest in Kerala. There's no problems.
Sir, experience in Kerala, there are investments in Kerala. Yes.
So,
sir, personal experience?
We are investing in Kerala. What is the project that we have to study? We are investing. Ramit Litton, Stala, Rana, and then investiga. Then the government or Nala deal on Taka. The government as well as Union United, then Nala deal business. A
father and the prim strike color state. I'm going to do image Namala Badik.
Marvirum from Alkari Pabilla, Istanbul Alkari Julie, the cultureman shared the match on that. Thursiatum. When the Chinese are married with Julie, business here, the Petrum will invest in Alkari invest in China. അതുകൊണ്ട് അവിടെ ഈ ഫ്രണ്ട്ലി ക്ലൈമറ്റ് ആണ്, അതുപോലെ കേരളവും ഉണ്ടാകാൻ സാധ്യതയുണ്ട്. പത്മശ്രീ അവാർഡ് ഏറ്റവും അഭിമാനിക്കാവുന്ന ഒരു അവാർഡാണ്. ഗവൺമെന്റ് ഓഫ് ഇന്ത്യയിൽ നിന്ന് കിട്ടുന്ന ആദ്യത്തെ ബിസിനസ്, ഞാൻ ഫെയിലായി കേരള ഇന്ത്യയിൽ. കേരളത്തിൽ ബിസിനസ് ഫെയിലായി, പിന്നെ അതിനുശേഷം ഫെയിലായിട്ടില്ല. അതൊരു പാഠം പഠിച്ചു. ലോകത്ത് ഓൾഡ് ഏജ് ആണ് ലോകം മൊത്തം. ടീനേജുള്ള ലോകത്തെ ഏക സ്ഥലം ഇന്ത്യയാണ്.